I recall that awful feeling of growing horrors from my ceiling. Dripped noxious fluids which filled my room with a singular odor, a fetid fume, which should have served to warn me well that in the room above did dwell a fearful thing.
Care. I clambered up the creaking stair to the sepulchre wherein survived his deathless mind, a thing which thrived in the cool air in the frigid tomb. 'Twas death he fought in that Stygian gloom. Night after night I would visit there, regardless of the freezing air.
Within me grew, for his bloodless hands into a shoe. For more than an anxious mind could bear, in this laboratory with its cool air.
My host, the Wad, was not unkind, and he told me how the will, the mind, was stronger than organic life. His enemy death, and with death his strife. He raved then of outlandish schemes, of sorceress rites, unholy dreams, where the demons howl, dark planets roll through a universe both lifeless and cold.
A blasphemy, he took a leap. As arcane rites became his grief, as precious faith burned.
Bubbling vials were but scientific trials, or so he claimed, but then I knew, and thus the dread within me grew. Night after night I would visit there, regardless of the freezing air. Cold as death, it leached my will. I lost my mind in the morbid chill.
Must have cool air. This won't suffice. Bring ice, bring ice.
succumbed to fear, whispered fell into my ear, a thing I cannot bear, and yet I laughed as if I could forget. I laughed as only the mad can do, and then I shrieked, for then I knew he spoke the thing which confirmed my fears.
I have been dead for 18 years.
I can't abide.